Now, I think you're going to see a guy who will go that inch with you.
Hell yeah.
You're going to see a guy who will sacrifice himself for this team because he knows when it comes down to it, you're going to do the same for him.
Hell yeah.
That's the team, gentlemen.
Hell yeah.
Face.
What's going on, y'all? You already know what it is. This is Tune In Sports. I am the voice for Cavs fans. Let's talk about it, man. I'm a little under the weather, so bear with me, man. Bear with me, man. But yeah, let's talk about it. Let's talk about, you know, the game, man. Shout out to Bruce. I already know why you laughing. I know why you laughing, bro. I know you see the title. You see the You see the thumbnail, and you just, come on, man. I know.
What?
They're trying to get political.
Yeah.
Look at this shit.
So, Bruce is laughing at Mook. That's what he's laughing at. So, I ain't, you know. shout out to Thomas, man. He said, did he say that? I guess you referring to the title, right? Yeah, I said it, man. I said it. Go ahead, you can laugh.
What?
I said it, man. But look, I ain't gonna hold it too long, man. You know, it's the Charlotte Hornets. I wanted to talk about it real quick. I'm still under the weather. Been under the weather for a couple of days now, man. But hey, grind don't stop, man. But let's talk about it though, man. The Cleveland Cavaliers, they defeated the Charlotte Hornets 115-92. So this was a team effort, man. You see, I played in the intro. Y'all, if you know my movie people out there, man, y'all already know what movie that was, man. But team effort, man. And looking at the team stats, you have, you know, the Cavs is getting back to one of their formulas. We shot 41 threes on 41% shooting. And yeah, man. And the Cavs recorded a season high 41 assists on 46 made shots and last night's win, which was 115-92. And according to Cavs notes, it was the 13th time this season that the Cleveland Cavaliers held their opponent under 100 points. And really, man, I mean, they held them under 100 points. But, like, really, you know, Hornets are one of the worst teams in the NBA. So let's be clear, right? Let's be clear. They 2-8 in their last 10 now.
That's garbage. That's garbage.
And now they 17-54 now for the season.
That's garbage. That's garbage.
Right? They are the worst rebounding team in the NBA. They ranked 30th in that department, and we out rebounding them 47-33.
That's garbage. That's garbage.
So yeah, like Hornets is just like, this was a good win. The Cavs needed it. The fans needed it. But the Hornets is just not really that good. And they are missing guys also, like LaMelo and more, but they still garbage. They garbage.
That's garbage. That's garbage.
They garbage. You know, it really ain't nothing to brag about, right? So they missing people. We missing people. Donovan Mitchell, Max Strus, you know, he's still out. But and Dean Wade, but they will be available soon, sooner than later, man. My thing is just get Donovan Mitchell 100% healthy. Get him ready for the playoffs, man. You know, of course, get him back in time to get it back in rhythm right before the playoffs. But this is the Hornets, man. Yeah, man, like the Cavs, you know, they did what they were supposed to do especially after that embarrassing loss against the Miami Heat. I don't have to rekindle. I don't have to, you know, revisit that. But the Cavs, they handle business. They protect the home court. They beat a bottom feeder in the Charlotte Hornets. For me, I mean, I'm not impressed, right? I'm not impressed. I'm happy for the win, but I'm not impressed. But it does help with the morale, and it do cool down fans a little bit that's really on the edge right now with this team. But, yeah, again, it's the Charlotte Hornets.
That's garbage.
I don't mean no disrespect to Charlotte, man, but I'm talking about the team in particular, man. It's just, yeah, man, it's the Hornets. So, and, yeah, look, check this out. Y'all want to hear the good news? I have good news. Y'all want to hear it? We play them again tomorrow. What? We play them again. So this is good. This is good for the Cavaliers. We could rack up on another win for now. Because the stand is looking real shaky for us, especially with the injuries and teams, you know, is creeping up. It's looking shaky for us with the Bucks getting the second seed back, and the Knicks is creeping with the Magic. The Pacers just got a win last night against the Clippers. Excuse me. So, yeah, as far as I see it, we need to stay at that three spot, man. If we fall to the four, all right. But we need the home court advantage, in my opinion, and we have to focus on matchups. So we just got to keep that in mind, man. But, you know, looking at the box score again, man, shout-out to the guys. Shout-out to the guys. So Evan Mobley had a good game. Everybody, for the most part, had a good game. Evan Mobley had 17 points, 8 for 12. You know what I'm saying? He took two threes. I'm not mad at that because that's gonna be a part of his game. You know, he needs to unlock if we're gonna keep this, you know, this double big lineup thing going. Excuse me. And he also had 7 rebounds, and he had a career high with 8 assists. So that's dope right there. They moved the ball this game. Jared Allen also scored 17 points with 13 rebounds, and he had 4 assists. So the bigs is out there, you know, assisting the ball. Isaiah Okoro, 14 points, 5 boards. He took 7 threes, but he only made about 3. Darius Garland, 15 points, 10 assists, and 4 rebounds. So I know some people still not happy with DG. I'm not happy with DG, but I just keep in mind, you know, of him trying to get back. He had a double-double this game. So 15 to 10, I'll take it, man. We got the dub against the Charlotte Hornets. I'll take it. LeVert, man, Cavs LeVert, man, he shot poorly from the field. He had 7 points, but also had 7 across the board. So he had lucky 7s across the board. He had 7 points along with 7 assists and 7 rebounds. So hopefully LeVert, come playoff time, we could get that consistent LeVert from, you know, scoring-wise, because we're going to need his scoring in the playoffs. He's one of the few that can, again, create his shot. You know, we don't have many, but he's one of the few that can create a shot that's coming off that bitch. So we need LeVert to get going before the playoffs, man. But he has been still facilitating and grabbing boards. So I like that about what LeVert been doing. Again, 6th man of the year for me. He's not going to win it, but he's my vote. He got my vote, but he's not going to win it. George Niang, so, the fan favorite. I say that sarcastically, man, but he's going to be earning, you know. He been earning his respect, man. George Niang finished with 17 points off the bench. 5 for 10 from downtown, and in his last 10 games, he's been shooting almost 44% from the three. So he's coming along, you know what I'm saying? He's coming along. As we clamp down the season, I think George Niang been playing a lot better than what we've seen, you know, beginning with some of y'all was going crazy about him, man. All I heard about George Niang was he ain't this, he ain't that. He can only do one thing, man. Let me play this quick audio, man. Let me play Bubba. Shout out to Bubba, man. He told me the Yang ain't this. Let me just play this quick audio.
He's not playing with James Harden or Joel Embiid, who he can have all the space in the world to shoot that three, bro. If his shot's not falling, he can't play no defense. He can't create his own shot. He can't create for his teammates. Bro, what we doing, bro? He can't guard nobody. Come on, bro. Bro, come on, bro.
Wait. All right. That's Bubba, man. Shout out to Bubba. Bubba, you got to get that hate out your heart, man. You say he can't do this. He can't do that. Last time I checked, he ain't been not only shooting the ball, but he been taking it to the basket. He been doing things I ain't think he could do. You know? Shout out to Niang, man. And you said, you know, he's shooting almost 44% in his last. He's shooting 43% in his last 10 games. So Niang been coming around. And shout out to Sammy Buckets, man. Sammy Buckets. Sam Merrill, 12 points off the bench with 4 of 8 shooting all threes, of course. And he had 4 rebounds. And honorable mention off the bench, shout out to CPJ. Shout out to Craig Porter Jr. He's been having some, you could say, tough stretches, but this is definitely one of his better games with 9 points and 4 assists. And he made 1 3. Some people don't think he can shoot the three, but he actually can shoot the three, but probably not at the level you expected him to shoot it at. But yeah, man, I'm satisfied. Shout out to Humble. Humble in the building. We on the same time of tune. Get better, fam. Yeah, absolutely, man. You know, I gotta keep it coming though, man. I gotta, you know, want to get this out, but I gotta, after this, I'm gonna, you know, take me some Dayquil or something, man. But again, it's the Charlotte Hornets. Nothing to get too high on, nothing to get too low about. The Cavs won. Gotta be happy about that, man. But let's fast forward. Let's talk about the Junkyard Dog of the game, man. Y'all already know who the Junkyard Dog is, man. So let's talk about the Junkyard Dog of the game, man.
You, what is your profession?
I'm a punter.
Spartans! What is your profession?
This is where we hold them. This is where we fight.
We are with you, sire.
This is where they die.
For Sparta, for freedom.
Today, no Spartan dies.
Prepare for glory.
Remember this day, Spartan, for it will be yours.
This is madness.
For all time, this is Sparta.
Nullified, but we now wait to see whether this will be a flagrant foul, and if so, a flagrant one or a flagrant two. A flagrant one is one that's unnecessary. A flagrant two is unnecessary and excessive. Flagrant two carries with it an ejection, and we are going to have to see.
It's going to be one or the other. I mean, but at the same time, I like the fact that the physical play, because those are the situations that you have to send a message to the league.
After review, the illegal contact occurs prior to the start of the upward shooting motion. Therefore, the shot does not count. As it relates to a flagrant foul, the play has been upgraded to a flagrant foul penalty too. Marcus Morris has been ejected from the game. Unnecessary and excessive contact. It'll be 2 shots for Richards. Charlotte's ball, side out.
So Morris heads down the runway and back to the Cavalier locker room as he has been nullified.
Come on, Gucci Mane. Was that Gucci Mane? I think that was Gucci Mane right there. That's the Gucci Mane on ref. Come on, Gucci. And shout out to that Clippers fan in the audience, man. I think she had the Mook jersey on. She had the Morris jersey on. Shout out to her. Look. He's the Junkyard Dog of the game. I know. And Humble, I'm going to talk to you, Humble. I got to holler at you, Humble. Humble ain't feeling it, but I'm going to talk to you, bro. I'm going to holler at you on this, man. But look, this the only highlight I got from this game. I don't have no highlights of him scoring the ball or nothing, man. This was basically the highlights.
Shame. Shame. Shame.
What?
They're trying to get political.
Yeah.
What?
That's what it was, man. That's the only highlight I had, man. Look, this Marcus Morris only played 8 minutes. He hit 1-3. So Marcus Morris was ejected in that first half for throwing his elbow at Nick Richards in the neck area. Excuse me. I mean, like, after Morris got ejected because they called it a flagrant too, you know, the Cavs just kind of got it going from there, man. It was, you didn't know where this energy was coming at, you know, before that, the game was just like, yeah, okay, let's see. And after that, you know, I felt like that gave the Cavs, I feel like that gave the Cavs a spark. The ejection gave the Cavs a spark. And that's why Morris get the junkyard dog chain, man. That is why he will be on his team going forward for the postseason. You know, every team needs a guy like this. Every team, and what he did was, I was talking to Humble got his opinion, and I was telling Humble, man, Humble didn't believe, like, he couldn't believe that my man Mook got the junkyard dog chain. I'm like, yeah, it ain't always about the box score. Excuse me. So what Mook did, he sent a message, not only to the NBA, to the Eastern Conference. Right? That's what he did, right? You need players like this, Humble. I'm talking to Humble right now. This is what you need. The Cavs got a spark. They told you in the conference that Morris thing was a spark. You know, they got back. Look. He's going to be here for the postseason. Every team needs a player like this. I know the non-Cavs fans out there, they was going on a fuss about Morris Flagrant. I seen it. They demanded that he be suspended for they demanded that a 10-day contract dude be suspended for the rest of the year. And that's just ridiculous, bro. That's stupid.
Shame. Shame.
This is what the greatest thing about sports is. You play to win the game. Hello? You play to win the game. You don't play to just play it. That's the great thing about sports. You play to win. And I don't care if you don't have any wins. You go play to win. When you start telling me it doesn't matter, then retire. Get out. Because it matters. This is what the greatest thing about.
You play to win a game, man. Stuff, look, there's some mixed reactions from Cavs, you know, the Cavs fan base. Including Humble. You know, Humble, including Humble. But this is what you gotta understand, man. You can't be soft come playoffs. Not saying that throwing elbow, like, that's not, of course, that's not basketball. Like, nobody wanted to just throw elbows all game. But what I'm trying to say is, look, you can't be soft for the playoffs. The playoffs is not for the weak. I promise you it's not, man. We seen what happened last year. That let's have fun stuff, and which they had fun this game. That's cool. Shout out to the Cavs. They had fun this game. But that let's have fun stuff, it won't fly in the playoffs. You need bullies, man. You need to be mean. You need to be tough, man. You need to be physical in the playoffs. Look at Miami, man. They about business in the playoffs, man. You keep thinking, how in the world is this team with this much talent, because they got talent, but you know, they playing with less, right? lesser than other teams around the league. You keep thinking, how Miami keep getting back to back? How they able to get, you know, to the finals or be a playing team and be the top team? It's different, man. They got that the mindset, the heat culture, the team, the defense, the coach. They got all that over there in Miami, man. They got dogs over there too, man. They trying to win. That's what Miami's about. They trying to win. They got vets. They got it. Miami's about business in the playoffs. And look, and this is what I'm trying to tell Humble. Like, nah. They're going to sign Mook, right? They're going to sign Mook. Mook is a guy you need. Because this team is around a league, this team is viewed as soft. That's facts. Whether you want to say it or not, you look around the other teams, you might find some other teams that's considered soft. But this team is viewed as soft, especially after what happened last season. Even with Tristan Thompson in the game, the team is still viewed as a soft team, right? Teams, they only respect Spider, man. I mean, like, what I'm saying is they only worry about Spider. Like, they're not worried about, they should be, but they're not worried about no Mobley. They're not worried about no Jared Allen. They're not worried about no DG, especially right now. Like, look, check this out. I'm going to put something up here, right? Check this out. Bear with me real quick. But Donovan is this team, man. He's the reason why this team, you know, is relevant again, you know, as far as contending-wise, I'm saying. Check this out right here. Check out Blood, man. And Blood, and look, and Humble, you don't know this, man. You wasn't around. But, man, read what Blood said, man. And I could, look, this ain't the first time Blood, I ran into Blood a few times before this, man. Read what Blood just said, man. Read what he said. Hey, man, I told you last time, I'll tell you again, brother. DG not like that. Cavs going to get swept by any team that isn't new to the playoffs. Too soft.
Check out the big brain on Brad. You're a smart motherfucker. That's right.
You're a music artist, musically.
You know what I'm saying?
So you're not disrespecting me. You just kicking facts. Are you kicking your opinion? No, listen.
I said that from
no,
the beginning.
Listen, Charlotte. Is that an opinion or is that a fact?
I would think it's a fact.
No, ain't no goddamn fact.
These are all opinions.
Is that an opinion or is that a fact? Right? We don't know. Right now, that's just an opinion because we didn't even get to the playoffs yet. But based off last season, we know how the story ended. And shout out to Blood, man. Blood, like I said, this ain't the first interaction I have with Blood. Blood was here last playoffs. He commented, I call him a troll, but Blood was here last playoffs. He told me, he said, yo, and he was the only one. I had a couple Knicks fans talking crazy. He said, yo, he told me the Knicks was going to destroy the Cavs in 5 games. I had people in the comment section. I had my peoples saying, you know, Cavs is going to win in 5. Cavs are going to win in 6. Because realistically, the Cavs are supposed to beat the Knicks. Because you're just going off of, I guess, looking at the talent on paper, the Cavs are supposed to beat the Knicks. But it's more to that, man. It's more to that. But he said, yo, the cat, you know, and shout out to I had people in saying the Cavs gonna win in 5 or 6. And I was like, nah. I had somebody in, I think, yeah, he said 5. I said, nah, we not gonna beat the Knicks in 5. It's gonna be a little, it ain't gonna be that easy, man. You know. it's not going to be that easy. And he said we was going to lose in five games. And I kept hope alive. I kept on every game. It got, because after that game too, it started getting worse when we went to New York, man. I kept hope alive. I said, yo, the Cavs going to make a comeback. And game by game, I kept being delusional. And he told me Jalen Brunson was coming. That's what he said. The Cavs lost. Cavs got gentleman sweat, man. This is how some people feel about the. He's not the only one that think like this. I'm just saying. And Blood, yeah, Blood. He what he said last time came true, man. But right now, you ask some people who you know, fans of the Cavs, especially some Cavs media, they'll tell you right now, the Cavs don't got a chance against the team that's above us.
Why can't you change your thinking? Everybody else does.
Because I'm a fighter. That's the way I'm made, Adrian. That's what you married. We can't change what we are.
Yes, you can.
You can't change anything, Adrian. All we can do is just go with what we are.
You can't go with what you are. Have you read the papers? Do you know what everybody says? It's suicide. You've seen him. You know how strong he is. You can't win.
Adrian always tells the truth. No, maybe I can't win. Maybe the only thing I can do is just take everything he's got. But the baby, he's gonna have to kill me. And to kill me, he's gonna have to have the heart to stand in front of me. And to do that, he's got to be willing to die himself. I don't know if he's ready to do that. I don't know.
You can't win. That's what everybody's saying. You can't win. You can't win. You can't beat these teams. And the Cavs, they ain't going to go out without a fight, man. I need Donovan to be 100% healthy, but what I'm saying is that's how people view the team. They view the team as soft. I, other fans of other teams, they don't trust the Cavs. They literally don't. They won't even pick the Cavs because of what happened last season. So they would never pick the Cavs again. They can't trust the Cavaliers. This is facts. This is around fans of other teams. I spoke with them. This is how some other fans think. The Cavs are just. Some people feel like the Cavs are going to be a first-round exit again. If they don't, get this together, which is only a couple of games left with these rotations, getting everybody healthy and stuff like that. But Blood, Blood said it to, they solved DG. You might be right, man. I can't say nothing, man, about DZ, man. But I say the Cavs, they got embarrassed, and JB did get out coach last year. And Blood, I want you to come back playoff time. I got this comment up here, man. I'm still confident in the Cavaliers, bro, believe it or not, right? I got no choice but to be confident in this team, man. But Blood, I want you to come back playoff time. Come around, because you said sweet. You said the Cavs are going to get swept. That's what you said. So by what you just said right here, any team that isn't new to the playoffs. So basically what you saying, Blood, you saying the Cavaliers will be able to beat a team like the Indiana Pacers, the Orlando Magic, but Orlando Magic was in the playoffs. Well, that's a new team. But those are teams you're saying we will beat. But if it's not them teams, if it's the Boston Celtics, who's not new to the playoffs, the Bucks, the Knicks, the Miami Heat, you got us losing. No, you got us getting swept. Okay. So I'm going to say this. I'm going to be looking for you, Blood. I'm gonna be looking for you, bro. Cause I'm not. Look, Cav's not gonna get swept, man. Not this shit. It's not happening, bro. You gonna nah? Cause guess what, man? We got Donovan Mitchell, right? I still believe in this team with Donovan Mitchell leading the charge, man. Cause he's that good.
Whoo! If I didn't know no better, I'd tell you he's the greatest. I don't care what you say.
He's that good, man. So, you know, it is what it is, man. I'm riding with this team, man. Like I said, man, when the playoffs start, we're gonna be in the trenches, man. And we gonna see what is what, man. But we not getting swept. Not happening, blood. We not getting swept. And humble. And shout out to Tom with your agent. Yeah. I love that. You know, I love that sound bite, Thomas. Like, it gets me every time. The Rocky. Yeah, you know how it was with Rocky, man. It's always gonna be them people out there, man. People gonna talk. So you gotta prove them wrong, man. Prove the doubters wrong. But you know, I don't think I got on subject here, but just I'm piecing this in with the Morris thing, Morris being on his team. I'm going to play some audio about Morris in a few seconds, but humble, this is what I mean. Like, nobody think the Cavs is a threat, humble. When we was, you know, this is what I was trying to, you know, piece together, right? You know, the Cavs last year, right, we were secretly hoping to play the Nets. I guess that's a secret in the playoffs. Well, guess what? That Miami Heat, they is probably dreaming right now playing this young Cavs team who they don't believe can beat their zone. This is a Cavs team who haven't proved anything yet. You know, they've been in the playoffs and got bounced out. Teams are going to start to copy what Miami's doing. It's going to be – you're going to see that, man. It's a copycat league, right? They're going to see, you saw that with the Hornets. They were trying to do what Miami's doing. I'm like, what? I'm like, what are you doing? So I was like, Miami trying to, the Hornets trying to do what Miami was doing.
That's garbage.
I was like, yo, you're not that good. Stop it. Stop it, man. But look, and this is why I feel like, you know, and the soft allegations, Mook, you know, He brings something different to the table, man. Something the Cavs didn't have. Besides the, obviously he could space the floor out and other stuff like that. And you know, he brings something the Cavs need, man. They need dogs. They need, now I don't know where Morris gonna play come postseason, but they need this, man. They need this. So let me play this quick audio. Shout out to the Cavs inside. Let me play this quick audio for them. For Morris, for Mook. Let me play this quick audio.
Like I told the player, like I wasn't trying to like hurt him. I'm just being physical. And you know, last couple games, I laid up a couple players out. It just didn't go the same way. So you know, I'm just trying to set the tone, man. You rolling down the paint. Catching live, you know, we're trying to stop that type of shit.
You've been in this league long enough to know when a team is kind of going through a little tough spot.
Yeah.
Does it kind of feel that way, and is that why you felt like you maybe needed to?
Nah, I wouldn't say that part, but, you know, I just think, you know, it's been a lot of games, a lot of grueling games, so I just wanted to, like, just toughen us up, man, just, like, step in front of it, and, you know what I'm saying, like, listen, this is what is going to be expected moving forward, and not just for today, you know what I'm saying, like, start set the precedent, like, we going into the playoffs, like, and we're not just about to have anybody coming in here doing what they want to do, so, you know, that was just my point. It was just kind of like a message, but, you know, unfortunately, I didn't, you know, like I said, I wanted to play the game. I didn't want to get thrown up. I definitely wanted to, you know, put a little lick on it.
What did you think of the way the rest of the team responded after that, even if it was an unintended result?
I'm happy the way he responded, you know, and I was just, you know, like I said, man, I was just trying to set the tone, man. Like, we, you know what I mean, we were struggling a little bit earlier, you know what I mean, obviously our defense as well, but, like, you know, I'm trying to implement that no dunk rule and all that type of shit, because going forward, like, we're going to need that, you know what I mean, it's a lot of bigs in the East, and a lot of tough guys and a lot of tough games coming up. So, I mean, I just want to, like, just keep showing it, man. Just keep doing it and keep being tough and just keep, you know what I mean, keep setting the tempo, setting the tone.
So did you come back here and watch the rest of it?
I did. I went upstairs, worked out for a little bit, got my shots up. But then, you know, I started to see the shift. And then by halftime, we, you know, we got on the roll and, you know, we never looked back.
And did it click when you were watching, like, okay, that actually was the response? It was a cause
of effect? I was in between, man, because I was mad I got thrown out. Okay. So I was like in between, like, you know what I mean? Like, I never, you know, like, being tough, I never really, like, want to, like, you know what I mean, get ejected from a game because I still want to help my team. But I'm just happy we responded really well. And then going forward, man, like I told the team, like, each of these games has got to be treated like the playoffs. So if I got to, like, lay somebody out every game and we can respond like that, then it's so be it.
JB talked about the old school mentality and just being able to, like you said, the no dunk rule and things of that nature. Do you feel like you had to bring that veteran presence when you got here?
Yeah, I think, you know, that's just who I am. I mean, the league knows, players knows, you know what I'm saying? So without, like, me not bringing that, I'm doing the Clippers, I mean, the Cleveland Cavaliers a disservice. So it's like, you know what I mean? I have to bring that type of shit. Like, it's just in me, you know what I mean?
I appreciate you.
Yeah, appreciate it. You know, I told the player, like,
yeah. Now listen, that's called motherfucking bars, nigga. You know nothing about that. You know why? Cause you a mumble rapper, Bow Wow, a mumble rapper. Lil Yachty, you don't want nothing to. Neither you niggas want nothing. Cause Murder Mook is standing right there. Put him on the fucking camera. Mook, yeah. Now don't use the word M.
The temperature will be different. That M. Nigga sit next to me.
A lot of niggas duck. Anybody. That out here.
I'm that nigga.
We know niggas who duck.
Mook that
wreck.
Nigga.
We know.
Shout out to Mook, man. Excuse the language, but shout out to Mook, man. He was spitting bars, yo. I had to play it. He was spitting bars just now, man. I love Mook being for this team, man. Y'all don't understand. Y'all just don't understand, bro. He was spitting bars. A lot of y'all, flagrant, like, that's not bad. Nah, bro. What he did was he set the tone. That's what he did. Again, you need somebody like this for this team right here, especially this team. I don't think Mook would have been an asset to any other team in the East. This is the team he needed to come to. He set the tone. Do y'all know what set the tone mean? Do you know how the game was going? I still think the Cavs would have beat the Hornets, but he definitely set the tone. And that's why he got the chain, man. Shout out to Mook, man. He sent the message to the NBA. He letting y'all know what it is, man. It's not... It ain't basically he's saying it ain't sweet, bro. It ain't gonna be sweet. It's not sweet, bro. It's not gonna be sweet, especially come playoffs, man. That's when Niang even came out on, you know, saying it during one of his interviews he did. He said that bullying stuff, pushing us out the paint, getting rebounds. I posted it on my community tab. He said, I ain't gonna be that. Not this year, man. Not when I'm on the team. Y'all not bullying the Cavaliers. Now, I know some of y'all probably losing faith with the Cavs because they inconsistent, and you had to bring up the injuries, of course. Of course, you don't want to use that excuse all the time, but you have to keep that in mind. You know, you're missing Max Strus, Donovan Mitchell. Evan Mobley just came back. But shout out to Mook, though, man. We needed a guy like this. Like, Niang was doing little stuff like that, but Mook is just – Mook be wild. Mook is wild, man. Shout out to Mook, man. But he was spitting bars, though. That's how I feel, right? That's how I feel. Marcus Morris is currently on a 10-day contract that is up on Thursday. And I'll be the first to tell you, right? They will bring Morris in for the rest of the season for the playoffs. That's going to happen. Every team needs enforces, or you know, every team for the most part. Excuse me, pardon me. Every team needs them guys, them edgy guys, them the toughness. You need the toughness on this type of team right here. You need a player who's gonna bring energy. You need a player who's gonna light a spark. You need a player who's gonna do the dirty work. You need a bully. You need bullies too. You need a bully like Morris. Like, we can name players. That does stuff and it sparks like something, man. It'll bring energy. You got the Pat Bez out there who's a dog. You got Boogie, you know, shout out to Boogie Cousins. Boogie Cousins was, you know, but like, think of it like what I don't even want to compare the two. This might be kind of like, think of like what Draymond is to the Warriors. Like, I hope I'm not saying that wrong. I don't want to say that wrong. And, you know, Draymond is like, he's worse in terms of the antics and he's over the top. So I'm not even saying Mook is like that. Either Mook has moments too. But like, I just want to like say, like, think of it like that, right? Or like, because Draymond in that series, remember that we go back to that Boston Celtics series. We love or hate Draymond, and a lot of people hate his antics, man. He's been doing it for a long time. But that the Warriors, they punked the Celtics, bro. that finals, y'all know what I'm saying? That's what I'm talking about. That finals, Draymond, some people felt like they punked the Celtics, bro. Grant Williams, all them dudes, man. We know what Draymond is to the Warriors, man. You know, his antics, his defense. I'm trying to explain it, man. But Draymond was doing, you know, they was getting busy or whatever, man. But with Mook is important, right? Mook is important. And I don't want to compare the two with him and Draymond, but I'm trying to find a fair comparison for you to understand what I'm saying. But or you could think of like a former Cavalier who was here strictly just to be muscle and not play. Think of like a Kendrick Perkins, right? And Kendrick Perkins ain't really play at all. He got in like that one time when we played the Boston Celtics. Was it the Boston Celtics game? Yeah, I think it was the Celtics, and we threw him in there. And he threw, what's the call, to the floor? I think it was, who was it? I think it was Jay Crowder. That series was a little chippy. Everybody was, you know, on one. But, like, think about, like, Kendrick Perkins. My only thing is I think Morris will actually have an opportunity to play and not just sit on the bench. And, you know, he still be useful. But, like, I told Humble, I said, yo, I have no problem on what happened yesterday. I have no problem with that at all, man. He's a Cavalier, so he good, man. We need more dogs like Mook on this team. This team needs somebody like Mook, man. I have no problem with it, man. That's what I'm trying to get you to understand. He said, yeah, Tom is crazy. T says he Celtics got bullied. You know what happened, man. I don't want to revisit the old stuff, man. But, yeah. We got the Celtics up out of here, man. Yeah, Tyler's is gas. Tyler's gas. But we got the Celtics up out of here, man. I ain't bringing the old. This the new Cavaliers. I ain't going to revisit that. That's why T-Swizzy don't like LeBron. You know, LeBron hurt a lot of people's feelings, man. But, nah. Seriously, though, man. But, yeah, that's what I was just trying to tell Humble, man. Like, you need a guy like this. I have no problem what happened yesterday. That obviously that did something for the team, right? Because playoffs, it's not going to be hugs and smiles or tag you with. It's not going to be that. That's where you separate boys from men. It's going to get physical for this team, man. It's going to be physical play, man. Some of the games refs are starting to let teams play, man. It's not going to be just fun. Like, you got to go out there and play, man. It ain't all about that, man. It's about getting down, man. It ain't gonna be no tag you with, bro.
The world ain't all sunshine and rainbows. It's a very mean and nasty place, and I don't care how tough you are, it will beat you to your knees and keep you there permanently if you let it. You, me, or nobody is gonna hit as hard as life. But it ain't about how hard you hit. It's about how hard you can get hit and keep moving forward. How much you can take and keep moving forward. That's how winning is done. Now, if you know what you're worth, then go out and get what you're worth. But you got to be willing to take the hits and not pointing fingers saying you ain't where you want to be.
Got to be willing to take the hits, man. and they can keep moving forward, man. It ain't, I'm telling you now, the season is coming to an end. It was cool. We had a lot of fun with these games, some ups and downs. But playoff time, man, it's different story, man. But as far as Mook, man, Mook is a vet who knows his role, and he's been to two Western Conference Finals, right? I believe, right? He's been to two Western Conference Finals, if I'm not mistaken. He basically letting people know what's up. We're sending this message to the Eastern Conference and the NBA. Man, shoot, if I could, I'll play him against the Knicks if I could, if I know what I was getting out of him. But, yeah, man, like, that's just what it is, man. And I'm not the only one saying, like check out what Jerry Allen said.
He's only been here a couple days, a couple games, but the impact he's had on this team in terms of just how much we follow him, how much we listen to him, and how much he, you know, gets us going. We respect him in every single way, and it's like, you know, one of our guys got ejected, so it's like we wanted to play and not let him down. He's only been here.
So they wanted to keep playing, not let him down. That gave him a little spark and a little energy, man. They wanted to win the game. They knew Mook wanted to be out there. And Mook wanted to be out there, but he got ejected. He ain't want to get ejected. That's not what he's trying to do. But he's just, like, letting the people know, like, yo, you ain't about to do that. We're gonna hit you every time you try to do that, you know? He said if he got to lay you down, if he got to lay people down every single game, to get this team to where they need to be at and toughen up, he gonna do it. That's what Mook said. Look at that next game with Ben Simmons. When Jared Allen got into it with Ben Simmons, we was getting into it with them, and after that we went like on a 21-0 run against the Nets, man. So it's just like, you know, I know here come the Knicks. I know, man. Some people, look, I'm not. We'll visit that when we get there, man. I want to see the Knicks, man. I'm tired of the Cavs can't beat the Knicks. I'm tired of that talk. But, you know, we're going to see when we get there. But, yeah, man, Mook sent a message to the NBA. I feel like this is like, look, before I get ready to get out of here too, man. Let's play this. I'm gonna play this audio from my show that I did, right? I did a show on the pull up show. I'm gonna play the audio, man. And we were just talking about the vets, having that vet, right? Having that vet in the locker room, you know. Having that guy, it makes a difference, you know. I'm gonna play this audio real quick. Pardon me, man. I'm sick. Pardon me, but let me play this audio. I was having a conversation with the Real Leezy, right? Shout out to the Real Leezy, man. Warriors fan. You know, knowledgeable. Let me play this quick audio.
I'm gonna keep it 100 with you. You know what I thought hurt y'all when y'all traded Kevin Love? Everything that I just finished explaining right now, that was the piece that was going to keep him grounded and support him through all the rough times and the rough patches when the game ain't going well for him on offense. Kevin Love was that veteran player that he needed. Kevin Love went and took that over to Miami, and we've seen what Miami did. When, as soon as Kevin Love got there, Miami changed into a different team. And I'm not talking about what he provided on the court. See, people need to understand what, you know, having a locker room guy and having certain veterans who can keep you grounded and make sure they hold you accountable when you're slacking off, when you're not being a leader, when you're not working hard in practice and all that stuff. That's where it really starts. And that's why I say Donovan Mitchell needs that type of presence. But they gave Kevin Love away. See, when they had Kevin Rubio Love, and Kevin Love was balling. See, yeah, but Rubio isn't that type of guy, bro. That's an international guy. You know what I'm saying? Okay. And Rubio ain't never really accomplished anything.
International guy. Jokic is international.
No. What I'm saying, you said who?
You said international guy. Jokic is international. What does that
Jokic mean? Is international, but he had DeAndre Jordans, Jeff Green. Like, you know what I'm saying?
Oh.
Yeah. No, are you understanding what I'm saying? Y'all have to look at basketball. Let's just take the skill and what they provide on the court, take that out of the equation. Look what they did with the veteran pieces, like the Reggie Jackson came up over there. Like, those are key pieces to keep teams grounded in practice.
Reggie
the
Jackson.
Things that we don't see. No, I'm saying Reggie Jackson has been around the league for a long time. You see what I'm saying? He's been in playoff series before with the.
Do y'all understand what he's trying to say, man? And we did, and a lot of, you know, we did give up Kevin Love, which was, some people felt like that wasn't a good move, but we know why Kevin Love had to go. We know why. But that's, let me finish playing it, but that locker room presence that he's speaking about, man. And we have that with Tristan Thompson. That's why it was, excuse me. That's why Tristan Thompson come here. I like that signing. Some people was like, yeah, Tristan Thompson is washed and stuff like that. But we was missing that veteran leadership, that veteran voice. I know he said Rubio, you know, and we see how Rubio turned out. But you was missing, especially when Rubio wasn't coming back, you needed that veteran who actually been to the NBA Finals, by the way, and actually know what it takes. Like, do you understand? Let me finish playing the audio. And shout out to Bruce. I forgot Bruce is on here, too. Shout out to Bruce.
OKC Thunder and other teams. Like, you know what I'm saying? The Clippers. So he has that veteran presence that you need sometimes to get your team to a different level. And that's what we've seen with the Joker. You know what I'm saying? I'm just keeping it 100 from, you know, all angles. This is just goes beyond just on the court. This is leadership. You know what I'm saying? You have to have those type of guys in your locker room. It's going to be hard for certain players to get over him when you don't have those type of guys. That's all I'm saying. I'm with y'all. I'm going to keep it 100 with you.
And I like what the real Elizy was saying, man. You know, he gave some insight on that, man. You just got that locker room presence, man. That guy, that you got that with Tristan Thompson. Like, the stuff that you don't see that's happening behind the scenes, that's happening in practice, man. Pushing these guys, you know, pushing their limits. Like Mook, not just your time, but Mook, man, he's gonna bring a different side. Now you can't teach toughness. You either got it or you don't, man. You know, but Mook is gonna bring something out of this team, man. We at the end of the part of the season, but he's gonna motivate these guys, hopefully, man. He said it, man. He said, if I gotta lay a dude out to get through to this team, like, we not, like, basically he said that last year stuff is not happening. Like, these guys are saying that. He's not the only one saying that. Guys like Niang is saying that, right? And I told you already what it was, man. He's trying to bring he got that old school mentality, right? Kind of like, yo, this ain't 90s basketball, man. This ain't old. Yeah, I know, man. But look, he got that old school mentality, man. He gonna let you feel like you coming in that lane. He gonna make you feel him. Pause, right? If it's necessary, if y'all want to pause, yeah. He gonna make you feel it, right? Like, that's how it is, man. That's why I'm excited about Mookie. Bring that energy that I think this team. Like, you don't always gotta impact the game scoring. We know that. That's what dudes that get the junkyard dog chain don't always go off with scoring, man. There's other things they do on the court. But you don't always have to impact the game by scoring. It's other ways you can impact the game and your teammates and stuff like that, right? There's just different ways that you can impact. But Mook, man, Mook is just letting it be known. Like, and to be clear, he wasn't trying to take out, like, he didn't mean nothing by Nick Richards. Like, okay. But he's a physical. This is physical player right here. We know what Mook, you know, we know what Morrison. We got clips of him on YouTube. But like, the Cavs gotta be physical, man. It's coming down to the end. Pardon me, I'm sick. You gotta set the tone, man. He just let it be known, like, you're not about to have nothing easy in this paint. That's basically just to sum it up right there. What happened last night? You're not about to have nothing easy, nothing, no lives, none of that, man. And you got to understand that Knicks series, it's like, we know we just played the Knicks this year. Not good. No Donovan Mitchell, but still, it wasn't a good game. And the Cavs have been labeled as soft. Like, this is facts. I'm not making this up. I'm not just reading. Like, it's fact. That's how people view the team, right? They call Mobley soft. Like, and Mobley was, you know, Mobley was getting busy. He was getting busy. But against the Hornets, right? Yeah, man. I like what Mook did. I have no, you won't hear me complaining about anything. Shout out to Bruce though. Bruce taking notes. Excuse me. He said Bruce taking notes. He said, here we go with the sound bites. Nah, I had to play it, man, because, you know, I like what the Real Easy was saying, man, about having that veteran. Now, I know you didn't agree with the whole, what you said, the DeAndre Jordan thing. Like, you, Bruce was like, what? What are you talking about, man? Nah, I wish I had that Russell Westbrook soundbite. But nah, I agree. Like, I like what the Real Easy was talking about, though, man. I agree. Like, but with the, like, I'm comparing this to Mook, of course. Mook is perfect. I don't want to say perfect, but he's good for the Cavs team. Cavs cheesing crazy, man. Cavs like, yo, we finally got some dogs. He said, yo, we finally got some dogs, man. That's what Cavs thinking about. Cavs just happy to be here, man. He like, yo, we finally got some dogs. With that 7 points, that the boy has 7 across the board. Cavs gotta be better though. Yeah, he gotta be better, man. Boy has 7. I ain't gonna lie though. He be getting them rebounds and assists though. No matter how he get it, he be getting it though. My 6th man of the year, man. My 6th man of the year. Forget the inefficient stuff, man. He's my 6th man though. Bruce said. He said, man, I can't say anything about other teams. Clippers, they soft like gummy bears, man. Yeah, that's soft. that's kind of soft. Yeah, I know, man. Hey, Bruce, I know, man. The Clippers and people, the Clippers supposed to be one of the favorites to win, right? And the Clippers going through a whole, y'all going through y'all own little mess right now. Cavs got the ups and downs, but Cavs got the ups and downs because of injuries. That's why the Cavs got their ups and downs. The Cavs is a good team. They still got things to figure out as far as the rotations come playoffs, who work well with who, how long this player should play with this player. Like, there's still things that got to be figured out. Cavs still a good team because the East is looking like we saw what happened to the Celtics. Celtics got, man, I don't know how that happened. But, yeah, it happened, man. It happens. But the Clippers, man, yeah, y'all going to do something right now. I heard James Harden say that the team don't have no identity. So he's the second person to say that the team don't have an identity. That's crazy, right? And Ty Lue, I saw the post game. Ty Lue was like, Ty Lue funny, man. I was laughing. I was like, yo, Ty Lue crazy. He's like, he was trying to, man, what you talking about, man? He said, man, look, I ain't worried about what he's saying. He basically tried to brush it off. Like, man, we got to be better. We all got to be better. That's what he was basically saying. We all got to be better, from coaching to the players. He said, what you mean the team don't have our identity? We got our identity. We do got identity. Crazy, man. Yeah, y'all down bad, man. I mean, I have hope for the Clippers to get it together. But, man, right now, I don't know. We at the end of the season. You talking about you don't got no identity, bro? Come on, man. And then you got James Harden. Some people might call him a diva for that. I'm curious to see what BJ say. I'm gonna pull up to the line. I want to see what BJ, what y'all talk about today, and see how y'all feel about the Clippers. Thomas said, wait to the playoffs, though, man. Right? Wait to the playoffs, man. Let's see what Kawhi do. Humble said Denver Clippers. Yeah, man, I had a poll. I got a poll. Yeah, I had a poll in the community tab, man. I think Nuggets is leading the way. They think the Nuggets are going to win the off. They got the Nuggets as the favorites on my poll, and I think they got the Cavs as the favorites on the East. I think that's how it still is. But You said Zubat not trying to see Joker at me. Hey man, don't let the hey man, Joker's a dog, bro. Joker's a dog. Joker's one of them, man. I don't think nobody wants. Like, I got the Nuggets. You know, one of my favorites. You said Cavs better than the Clippers right now? Nah. I mean, we did beat y'all, right? I might say. I don't know, man. A fully healthy Cavs team, sure. Because the Clippers is a mess right now. This version of the Clippers, yeah. The Cavs will beat this version of the Clippers. But come playoffs, I don't know what will happen. Maybe y'all get it together. But this version of the Clippers with no identity, yeah, a fully healthy Cavs team. Not this Cavs team right now. Nah, I think the Clippers will beat this Cavs team, even with y'all problems. But a fully healthy Cavs team with Donovan Mitchell, yeah, we'll beat y'all right now. With no identity, yeah, we'll beat y'all. Yeah, down bad. But like I said, every team got something going on, right? Or complain about something with their coach. Cavs fans, they don't agree everything with JB do. They have this stuff about JB they don't agree with. He's not a good coach. Some people might feel like that. Some people got they problems with Darius Garland and Evan Mobley. But really, Darius Garland. So really, the main people right now I think is Darius Garland and JB that people be talking about the most. I think. Darius Garland he has regress, you could say. Not that same DG and still second guessing himself. But yeah, Clippers. He said, I'm not biased, I am fit. I am crazy like so. Bruce, I know Bruce. I already know Bruce. We know Bruce. I don't know where Tom is at, but we know Bruce. I know you keep it fair. You're not delusional. You if you think the team is done, if they done up, they done up, man. Yeah, Bruce will tell the truth. He not biased. But hey, Bruce, I heard you on the other string. I thought you was confident. That the Clippers was gonna be okay. I thought that's what you said on the other string. But yeah, Cavs fans, man. Mook will probably most likely be here for the postseason run. You need that type of guy and that veteran presence, man. But to sum it up, this game, it was a good one for the Cavs. Way to move the ball. You beat a team you were supposed to beat. Let's be clear. You beat a team, one of the worst teams in the NBA, and we're going to have to do it again because we played them again. Let me see what Bruce said. About to give me some water, man. You said Cavs can beat the Celtics if they fully healthy. If Marcus Morris is under the bench and Tristan Payton. Yo, chill, man. Yo, sick right now. You about to make me laugh. You said Tristan Payton's child support and don't go to his supply. Oh, man. Come on, Bruce. Come on, Bruce. That take right there, man.
That's garbage. That's garbage.
I got hit you with the shame on that one, man.
Shame. 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 Shame.
Shame. Yo, Bruce crazy for that comment, yo. You crazy, man. He said Morris is at the under the bench and Tristan Payton's child support. So, man, I had no rebuttal for that, man. No rebuttal at all, man.
They're trying to get political.
Yeah. Hey, I hope Morris do play. I hope there is a time we could play Morris. I would love to see Morris in the playoffs. I know Clippers Nation was out on Morris, and he sucked for the team towards the end for y'all. But I like Morris. I like what he brings for this Cavs team. He said I was trying to have fun with her. I was trying to be positive. That was before last night discussing. Oh, okay. That was kind of crazy. I know Blaine Talu. I know, bro. I already know what it is. That was unacceptable though. At home though. No, was that at home? That was at home, right? Like you can't lose. Like you gotta protect on court, man. Can't lose, especially get blown out at home. You know what I'm saying? can't let that happen, man. And you just can't let that happen, man. Yeah, man. You know the grind don't stop. I'm trying to push through, man. And I didn't want to miss a day. I had to go live. And I wanted to talk about Mook. I had a, especially yesterday, man. It wasn't really nothing to talk about. It's the Charlotte Hornets. I mean, it's a good win, but it's not an impressive win. It's the Hornets. It's just good for the morale for the fans and team. But it's nothing to really brag about. It's the Charlotte Hornets. They trash. And I mean that respectfully. They trash. But it was a good win for the Cavs. And I had to talk about Mook, man. Mook got the Junkyard Dog chain, so I wanted to shout him out. But yeah, I appreciate that, man. Yeah, I appreciate that. I appreciate that though. Yeah, I'm definitely going to go and see what BJ talking about. See what y'all talking about. That was at home. Clippers been pissing me off. Yeah, man, y'all down bad. Hopefully, y'all get it together. It's late in the season, but you know. I don't want to hear none about no hit the switch. I mean, I don't know, man. That whole hit the switch stuff, it's a – man, you in the West, I don't know, man. So I don't know. And the way it's looking like, I don't know how it look, but y'all might see Denver in the second round. I know y'all say y'all not really worried about Denver. Y'all could beat Denver. If I'm not mistaken, that's what y'all was saying. But I think that's how it will look with the bracket. I think Denver will be a second round matchup if y'all able to get out that first round, and depending on the seeding. I think Denver's second right now, right? I think they're still second. But yeah, y'all not looking good, man. But yeah, man. Yeah. He said, Clippers fan hate me because I am not a crazy fan. Love. I will go off late. Hey, bro. Hey, Bruce, yo. You know, Bruce. You know, you and your takes, man. I know you when you talk about Donald Mitchell, man. But yeah, I know, Bruce. Bruce, you're not delusional. I know you're not delusional, man. You're not delusional. I know, bro. Andre not delusional either. Andre try to kick some facts and try to, you know, pull up and check and fact check some things. But yeah, man, I mean, you're not delusional, bro. It's all good, man. I hope the best for the Clippers, man. I do, man. I like Kawhi, but man, it's a team game, man. It's a team game at the end of the day, man. Coaching does matter. Like BJ said, coaching matters. Yeah, Cavs fans, coaching matters. Coaching definitely matters, man. And who on the other side of that floor, man? You know, Donovan Mitchell has been great this year. Yeah, Donovan Mitchell actually has been great this year, man. Despite the injury, it's the best Donovan Mitchell we've seen in a Cavalier uniform, because his playmaking, he was averaging a career high in playmaking, in assists and rebounds, and he was in the MVP conversation. And he was like top five in scoring, I think, for the injuries. And I think he was like second in steals. But yeah, man, he got hurt, so it's just like, yeah, it's on to the next man. Because his injury, he won't even make All NBA. He was on pace to make All NBA, but it's over now. Yeah, I agree. Do it in the playoffs. That's what. Like this whole team, not just Donovan Mitchell, him particularly, but the team itself got to do it in the playoffs. That goes from 1 through 15 or 1 through 10, depending on, you know, who you play come postseason. But yeah, that go for the team. I have not said anything about Donovan. Yeah, I don't think I heard you say anything or say anything bad. You know, I don't think I even heard nothing. So I'm starting to say it's before. I don't hate them. Nah, I know, Bruce. I know, man. It'd be funny, man. It'd be funny. You don't take it. Ain't nobody taking it serious, man. It's basketball, man. It's funny. You funny, Bruce. Bruce, one of the funniest people on the pull up show, man. He probably is the funniest on the pull up show. Oh, man. Humble said, can Bates get playtime against Hornets? Well, tomorrow, man, shoot. A lot of some fans feel like the JB should be playing the young guys more. But, you know, play the Hornets tomorrow, right? I mean, what you mean, like real playing time? Or you be like 4 minutes garbage time? Like, what you mean, man? Because I don't know, man. I mean, Evan Mobley's back. We only missing Dean Wade, Max Strus, and Donovan Mitchell. Craig Porter played. He got 14 minutes. Imani, and they played, but that was garbage time, right? Him and Pete Nance and Damian Jones, that was garbage time. But as far as real minutes go, probably not. Probably not. Maybe garbage time, especially if we blow the Hornets out. Hopefully, we blow the Hornets out, or at least win. Whatever, just give me the win, you know? Whatever, bro. I don't even care. I don't even care, man. But, man, like I said, man, it's a good win for the Cavs, man. Let's keep on winning. Seeding matters at this point. Health matters. But I do not want to fall from the third seed, bro. I really don't. I want to contain the third seed, bro. I really do. Because I'm just looking at the matchups right now, bro. And you don't want to see Miami in the first round. I have to say that, bro. You do not want to see Miami in the first round. Some people don't believe in my, like, I keep on sleeping on my Andre, Bubba, you keep on sleeping on Miami. But you said they play. You said they run an illegal defense, bro. That defense is crazy. It's the Hornets. Let bro get some. He says the Hornets. Let bro get some shots up. Man, look. Yeah, he could get some shots up if we win it. But man, we gotta win the game, man. I don't have no problem Imani playing, but man, we gotta win these games. I ain't got no time to be playing around and trying to get your last minute shots up, get your like nah, but he can get shots up when we got a comfortable lead and we about to win the game, yeah. Unless somebody get hurt, but yeah, man, nah, he get shots up at the end of the game. Or matter of fact, he get shots up before the game, pregame. How about that? that's no diss to anybody either. I'm just saying, bro. We trying to win these games, bro. But look. But Humble, you understand what I'm saying, man? Before I shut it down, do you understand why we need Mook? We need Marcus Morris Senior. Do you understand did I break it down enough, man, for you? Do you still feel like you still feel that way about last night with the flagrant foul? I hope I hope he broke it down. He broke it down. I played the audio. I'm gonna play it again. Come on, Bruce. Like, come on, bro. You was doing good, man. You was doing good. Now you sound delusional. Now you sound delusional.
Check out the big brain on bread. You're a smart motherfucker. That's right.
You're a music artist. Musically.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying?
So you're not disrespecting me. You just kicking facts. Are you kicking your opinion? No, no, listen.
I said never.
No, listen, Charlotte. Listen, Charlotte. Is that an opinion or is that a fact?
Hey, man, look. I don't know. Like, so far, I like what I saw from Morris. And I just like, even if he don't give you double digit points if he plays in a game, like, it's still the fact that I know what he brings on the court and off court. Know or during practices, right? The Cavs need a player like this, in my opinion. This is my opinion. The Cavs need a player like this, bro. Cavs is, they need toughness. They need dogs like this, bro. That's like, I don't know what's gonna happen in the playoffs.
Well, what I'm saying is that there are known knowns and that there are known unknowns, but there's also unknown unknowns. Things we don't know that we don't know.
I don't know, bro. We don't know what's going to happen in the playoffs. We don't know if the Cavs going to get out the first round. The Cavs might get to these conference finals. We don't know. I don't know what could happen. Injuries is part of the game. Like, so many factors that could factor in, you know, but he said it is a fact. It's not an opinion. It's a fact. I know, man. I know. I love it. I love it, man. I love it, man. I love it, man. Shout out to Mook, though, one more time, man. But yeah, I'm gonna play footage before I end the stream. But yeah, man, don't forget. Make sure y'all like, leave a comment too, man. If you have any comments about on the game or Marcus Morris sending a message to the Eastern Conference, and make sure y'all sub up, man. Also, man. You said dude scored 3 points to get the Hornets, zero rebounds, assists. Come on, man. Bruce, the man got ejected. He got ejected, bro. Come on. You gonna really do that? He got ejected, bro. Look, that zero, look, that stat, zero rebounds, 3 points, it ain't stopping for getting this. Look how happy he is, bro. I'm fooling around, man. I hope he able to prove you wrong, Bruce. So far, so good for Mook, man. But, look, man. I appreciate y'all, man. Y'all already know, man. Let them know. Go Cavs.
Hey, Coach, it seemed like when Marcus went out, it felt like the guys kind of rallied around him. You talked a lot about playing for each other. Did you feel the energy kind of up itself when he went out?
It changed the game. You know, again, it's one of those things. The game was kind of ugly and choppy and, you know, Marcus, you know, a little old school mentality impacted the game, and, you know, his teammates responded, and we went on a run, you know, following that. But I do think it brought energy to the group, you know, and it's, you know, again, it's like those types of players who understand the game at that type of level understand how to impact the game in different ways, and what, you know, can trigger an eruption. And I think that play did that for us.
He's only been here a couple days, a couple games, but the impact he's had on this team in terms of just how much we follow him, how much we listen to him, and how much he, you know, gets us going. We respect him in every single way, and it's like, you know, one of our guys got ejected, so it's like we wanted to play and not let him down.
He nullified, but we now wait to see whether this will be a flagrant foul, and if so, a flagrant one or a flagrant two. A flagrant one is one that's unnecessary. A flagrant two is unnecessary and excessive. Flagrant two carries with it an ejection, and we are going to have to see.
It's going to be one or the other. I mean, but at the same time, I like the fact that the physical play, because those are the situations that you have to send a message to the league.
After review, the illegal contact occurs prior to the start of the upward shooting motion. Therefore, the shot does not count. As it relates to a flagrant foul, the play has been upgraded to a flagrant foul penalty too. Marcus Morris has been ejected from the game. Unnecessary and excessive contact. It'll be two shots for Richards. Charlotte's ball, side out.
So Morris heads down the runway and back to the Cavalier locker room as he has been ejected.
That part, but, you know, I just think, you know, it's been a lot of games, a lot of grueling games, so I just wanted to, like, toughen us up, man. Just like step in front of it, and you know what I'm saying. Like, listen, this is what is going to be expected moving forward, and not just for today. You know what I'm saying. Like, start set the precedent. Like, we going into the playoffs. Like, we're not just about to have anybody coming in here doing what they want to do. So, you know, that was just my point. It was just kind of like a message, but you know, unfortunately, I didn't. You know, like I said, I wanted to play the game. I didn't want to get thrown off. I definitely wanted to, you know, put a little lick on it.
What did you think of the way the rest of the team responded after that, even if it was an unintended result?
I'm happy the way he responded, you know, and I was just, you know, like I said, man, I was just trying to set the tone, man. Like, we, you know what I mean, we were struggling a little bit earlier, you know what I mean, obviously our defense as well, but, like, you know, I'm trying to implement that no dunk rule and all that type of shit, because going forward, like, we're going to need that, you know what I mean. It's a lot of bigs in the East and a lot of tough guys and a lot of tough games coming up, so, I mean, I just want to, like, just keep showing it, man. Just keep doing it and keep being tough and just keep, you know what I mean, keep setting the tempo, setting the tone.
So did you come back here and watch the rest of it?
I did. I went upstairs and worked out for a little bit. Got my shots up, but then, you know, I started to see the shift. And then by halftime, we, you know, we got on the roll and, you know, we never looked back.
And did it click when you were watching, like, okay, that actually was the response? It was a cause.
No,
effect?
I was in between, man, because I was mad I got thrown out. Okay. So I was like in between, like, you know what I mean? Like, I never, you know, like, being tough, I never really, like, want to, like, you know what I mean, get ejected from a game because I still want to help my team. But I'm just happy we responded really well. And then going forward, man, like I told the team, like, each of these games has got to be treated like the playoffs. So if I got to, like, lace somebody out every game and we can respond like that, then so be it.
JB talked about the old school mentality and just being able to, like you said, the no dunk rule and things of that nature. Do you feel like you had to bring that veteran presence when you got here?
Yeah, I think, you know, that's just who I am. I mean, the league knows, players knows, you know what I'm saying? So without, like, me not bringing that, I'm doing the Clippers, I mean, the Cleveland Cavaliers a disservice. So it's like, you know what I mean? I have to bring that type of shit. Like, it's just in me, you know what I mean?
I appreciate you.
Yeah, appreciate that part, but, you know.
With the 49th pick in the 2023 NBA Draft, the Cleveland Cavaliers select Imani Bates from Eastern Michigan University.
Lesson, learning our lesson, and then applying all the things that we talked about. The effort that you guys put in on the defensive end of the floor was phenomenal. Okay? That was textbook Cavaliers defense. And then the offensive end of the floor, we shared it, we attacked the paint, we got what we wanted. Okay? That was a phenomenal job. Congratulations to this group, okay, for achieving something as a unit that we've never done before, okay? But we ain't done yet.
Hell no.
All right, let's go.